Hello.
Hello.
How does it feel to be hit with the fucking psychic narrative plot beats superpower?
It felt it felt like okay in the moment, I think, because I ended up bringing it back, but I was like, oh, uh-oh.
Can we come up with like a really long and obnoxious title for the Plus R tournament to match the Strive one?
How about WNFOC Online Edition Episode 4, Give the Gear X to XAxeCore Plus R, Feliz Jueves, brought to you by Wild West Guilty Gear.
That's pretty good.
It's already really long because of the title of the game, though, so I
It's
think.
true, that's
But
true.
yeah, that oh, a lot of our work is cut out for us there. All right, I'll let them know that bracket is final and that the stream is live.
Is Dog a Slayer?
I think so.
All right. Because we have Pichon Killer and Dog round one. So if that's a Slayer mirror, that sounds pretty cursed. Let's see, let's grab that one.
Basically, I think we should be good to go now. So we'll just we'll boot up the game, and then we'll get Tux on here, and then we should be totally fine.
Let me know when you have the Discord stream up.
Yep. Fact. There you go.
Whoa, it's up.
Yeah.
It's magic.
All right, private slot.
Please
Whoops.
select your character.
Right, here we go. And I'll make sure that they have the lobby stream too. I'm glad that we had have like a bracket, right?
Yeah.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah, this is like a respectable turnout. It's interesting that we're missing like a bunch of the usual killers, but we still
Yeah.
have Jason, of course.
I guess Jason isn't traveling to Frosty then, right? Which is really funny because Frosty's results would look totally different if he was showing up.
Can you imagine like the post-tournament tweets Jason would send out
If he
if he
won
won
like a
Frosty?
400 man tournament, yeah.
Yeah, I think this has to happen at some point, right? If once he's done like buying hats, he's gotta like use the Match Reno money to attend some major tournament.
Wait, Ironmonger, is he actually there? When does he plan on going to Frosty?
Oh god. I hope we're not like keeping him up to like fucking midnight, like the day before he has to get on a plane like at 7 a.m. or something.
Okay, that, well, okay.
I feel like this is like the 1 week when we're gonna have to like not give people shit for doing the whole like Mendokuse na. This is such a pain in the ass. I don't want to fight on a routine, you know? Because it's like,
yeah,
I wouldn't want to either.
Oh man! Like so then there's one of three things is happening here. Then so either he registered for Frosty and he's not going, which means he spent money on a tournament that he's not going to. He's on his way to Frosty and he's literally playing there, like we joked about, or he's not showing up here. And Joe Biden is registered under the name Tom Nook. Oh god.
Yeah, he's used that.
Yeah, he's used that
here, right? So that's probably him.
He's used Tom Nook, Sleepy Joe. He's used Joe Biden in Japanese. yeah. So I think that's probably him.
God. The one thing, like, I really appreciate how many just like fucking characters there are in the plus R bracket.
Yeah.
Like everybody in like the Strive one is like either like incredibly normie or kind of like a little bit of a toonie in a way that isn't endearing.
Yeah.
And then like the people here are just like they're real characters.
Yeah, they're like a sitcom cast.
Yeah.
It's like the community study group, basically. I think that might be like a really good way of putting it. Alright. Yeah, so conversely, no one, except for maybe Pichon Killer. Most of the stronger players are out this week. So, like, except for the Pichon Killer. I mean, everyone else is obviously very strong, but, like, the people that are, like, the most consistent against Jason, right? So, like, most of those guys are out. Because they're either running Frosty or at Frosty. So, Pichon Killer is probably the one that is going to stop Jason from, winning two in a row again.
Yeah, I would love to see a really unexpected upset, though.
Yeah.
That'd be really cool.
Imagine Sheenblade showing up again. And
oh my god, if Sheenblade showed up and eliminated Jason Riot,
yeah,
that would be the hypest shit.
Yeah. If only.
And then he'd never show up again, right? Yeah. After that, he'd like keep registering, but he'd never attend again.
Yeah. Oh, I knew I was forgetting something. People aren't here because I haven't changed the stream title yet.
I know!
I'm glad I caught that now.
I wonder if Jason got one of the Strive hats. I assume not because it's Strive, but...
Yeah.
They are hats.
Yeah. Maybe he wants the May hat. You never know.
Yeah, who knows?
The May cosplay was expensive. It was like over $100.
God. Like the hoodie?
The hoodie and the hat combined, I guess.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, he always, like... I don't know when this started.
Yeah.
He's been, like, talking about, like, oh, yeah, I need the money to buy a hat. I really want to buy a hat. I really want a hat.
Yeah, it seems like...
For a reason,
yeah, chat. It seems like that's what he's using the Vaturino money for. Is hats. This is just... seems to be a running gag. PS2 player. Jason would play Soldier.
Oh, he totally would. Right?
Like, he'd play Market Gardener as Soldier.
He'd play Market Gardener Soldier and still, like, top score somehow.
Yeah.
Soldier is definitely the soul of Team Fortress 2, yeah. I think.
Yeah. I think, like, definitely, he's definitely, like, very boring and middle of the road, but if you learn how to play as him, he could definitely be flashy in a deranged way. In much the same
yeah,
way
exactly. I used to be, like, okay-ish at rocket jumping, but, like, I realized at one point that having a shotgun is, like, more useful to the team, usually. I get Ubered for some fucking reason. So I kind of just stopped using gunboats and rocket jumping too much.
Yeah. I wasn't really good at rocket jumping, which is why I played demo, so that way I didn't have to aim anything. I just put the sticky down, and then I went. It was easier to control as demo. And then, of course, I just played Scout anyway, so... to cheat a little bit. But I was never good at crouch jumping. Which was, like, because of my pinky. That's just really awkward. I also never knew until, like, recently that the way you crouch jump is you crouch at the apex of the jump rather than at the beginning of it. So, like, I never...
I didn't know you're supposed to be doing that either. Huh?
Yeah. I guess it's because you crouch at the top and then your hurtbox gets smaller, but it gets pulled up rather than down. So, like.
Interesting.
Yeah, so that's what gives you the extra boost of height or something. Played TF2 almost entirely in 5th grade? Don't age us.
Yeah, for real.
Oh god, don't age us.
We're like in high school. God, is TF2 a retro game now? This sucks.
I guess, it came out in 2007, right?
Oh, fuck this. I mean, I would probably say that like Half-Life 2 counts as a retro game. But, like, I don't know if I'm ready to admit that, like, Portal or Team Fort is. This sucks.
God. Okay, well.
Wait, you played Team Fortress 2 and you're in 5th grade and now you're in college? Oh my god.
Yeah, see, we're done. Like, we're done.
I'm dead.
Yeah, we're done. We've been done for a while now. Oh no! This sucks!
This is so bad!
This sucks! This is the worst day of our life. Anyway, I don't know where Tux is. I'm gonna go at him real quick. Beer. Hey, Jason, are you in... hang on. Jason, are you in Chicago right now? You registered for Frosty and you're still here. When's your flight? You're the number 2 seed. And you're not going to show up the Frosty Fastings? You don't get any money from this one. You get money from the one on the weekend. Alright, I'll switch my gameplay screens over. The stream crashes, I apologize. For some reason, stream seems to crash whenever I switch the gameplay over. Okay, it looks like it all worked. Alright, good evening, everybody. It is now 7 p.m. on the West Coast, Pacific Standard Time. I'm like the R-Man. I'm joined once again, as always, by my co-admin, Kimberly.
Yeah, that's me.
And we are here running... What did I just say the full name was?
Who knows?
WFOC Online Edition, Episode 4, Guilty Gear XX, Axon Core Plus R, Release Jueves, brought to you by Wild West Guilty Gear.
Yeah,
there we go. Okay, that's the full thing. Alright, so... Okay, so Jason couldn't make his flight to Frosty. Jason, you registered for Frosty! You're the number 2 seed at Frosty Faustics!
Oh my god, this is the most in-character thing I've ever seen.
Jason!
Jason!
Why would... Oh my goodness gracious! I can't believe you. Anyway, as you may have just surmised, in case you didn't know by now, oh, that's odd. I don't know why it let you do that early.
Yeah, I know. It's just like one or two matches for each round of like coming up like before the rest of them for no particular reason.
Yeah.
Hello, Tux.
Hey.
Hello. Yeah, we're joined on commentary once again by Tux, my eternal rival. I fucking guess. Anyway, so this is the prelude to Frosty Faustings. Everybody who's here is presumably not able to make it to Frosty Faustings.
Presumably, if you're going to Frosty, you're on an airplane.
Yeah, so that means that most of... While we do have a host of killers here, like, we still have stronger players. Like, of course, like, Jason, who apparently registered for Frosty that didn't go.
Ha! After being seated number 2.
So Jason's here and not there. We still have players like Saison, you know, Joe Fishstone... Jacob Pat, Julio Rivera. That'll actually be a soul mirror if that happens. We have Wagner. Did I say Joe Fish already? Tip May Peach on Killer. We have a bunch of people here who are presumably not at Frosty, or they're playing on hotel or airplane Wi-Fi.
Please don't. No.
In the meantime, if you are, so we, as a result of that, we have a 16-man bracket, so it's very small. It'll be very short. Maybe it'll go by very quickly. But either way, we appreciate everybody signing up and coming out tonight. I genuinely didn't think we would have 16 people, let alone...
Yeah, we've had fewer people on nights where there wasn't a tournament the next day, so thanks for coming out.
Yeah. Like, let alone 8 people. Like, I didn't think we'd get like a decent sized bracket. In the meantime, since it looks like Smash GG is just letting everybody play, I'm gonna let winners round one play. It's about time for them to start anyway.
Talking about the Solmia, I had the most amusing experience earlier today in the Solmia, where we air dashed at each other at the same height and mashed JP very hard, and of course, clashed on the way down into clashing two piece for like 30 seconds.
Goodness gracious.
Yeah.
I'm really glad that someone else was able to keep you occupied tonight so that I could play other people. And also that you could get like a taste of your own medicine, although it didn't really seem to deter you.
Not really, no. That didn't really happen.
Yeah.
I mean, I got sidewinded because, everyone else actually knows how to do sidewinders except me. I don't need sidewinders.
Oh, God. Anyway, so round one, both of these players are no stranger to WNF, Saison versus Lurking. Saison the Kai, Lurking the Axel. This'll be really good. I'm sure they've played each other at some point. So, in fact, I'm pretty sure if I search through my VODs, I will have seen this matchup. If I go through it a little bit more thoroughly. So, Kai's Kai, Axel's Axel. Although Axel can play a little bit more aggressively in this game, Kai is still very much the boring white man. I'm not even gonna try to hide it.
Axel is British, though, so you know.
Yeah. This is.
French versus.
Yeah, this is. Yeah, yeah, yeah. This is.
That's
what this is.
Like classic.
Yeah, this is the War of 1812.
And like every other war ever in that part of Europe, not just 1812.
No kidding.
The bad blood has been very.
All right, so we get Saison taking it with the reactable overhead.
Uh huh. I will never block that.
Yeah.
Ever.
Alright, back for Lurking.
I won't
back
even block that offline.
We were born and bred in Exord, right? But I'm, even in Exord offline, I would never block that shit either. That's not even the Force Break version, and I would never block that shit. Alright, Lurking, poking Kai out of the air, to stop the air stun edges. Pushing Saison into the corner here.
The stun edges are still really good.
Ooh, good air throw. We wake up with Force Break Greed Sever to close out the round. So Saison takes game one.
Crossed up with the stop sign too.
Yeah. That looked really interesting.
It's almost like a delayed melty cross up.
Yeah.
Put out the attack first and then do the movement instead of doing the movement and then the attack.
I saw like a tech video in Central Fiction today where someone was like, hey, here's like a fucked up cross up that Mai can do. And it's like, if you spend like 50 meters to RC your drive in the corner, you can jump over it after throwing the projectile and then cross up your opponent and then do like a combo on 2C. But if they keep blocking your mix-up after you RC and throw your projectile, then you're bowed. So don't do this, actually. Anyway, hey, full auto.
But also
photos.
Do it because fake if it works.
Yeah. Yes.
That's the kind of bonehead nonsense I'm up to.
All right, so we get the Gohan overhead. All right. Now stays on the corner more. This round is looking a little bit more looking in favor. Although, let's keep that going. No pressure here. Oh, are we chunking out?
So chunked out. But yes, a nice six throw there.
Yeah, this looks really good. We got a short little bomber. Oh yeah, jumps right over the unblockable. We don't care about that. Okay. Oh man! Oh no! Oh, really bad read with the parry. He's just looking for this final hit. Okay, yeah. Oh, Lurky keeps blocking low. Lurky.
The parry missed, but the follow up to hit.
I really want to know what Lurking is looking for when. He blocks low so much. Like, I mean, 5k, sure, but I don't see a whole lot of, like, 2k, 2d, or Green Sever,
gonna, like,
or,
like, stuff
yeah.
Or, like,
yeah,
you know,
yeah, exactly.
Someone like me.
Yeah.
I would totally just raw stun them, though.
Okay. Alright, Lurking, holding on to his last little bit of life. Oh, gets crossed up. Okay. Yeah.
That's so, a real ambiguous cross up there, like literally right on top of the guy.
Yeah, I didn't block that. I've played against Sazon a bunch. I didn't block any of that. So Sazon moves on to round two, which I guess is what? Winner's quarters, actually. So,
welcome to 16-round bracket. Yeah. Hey, maybe it should be best of five.
Stop it!
Stop. That
all throughout, just like yesterday.
Oh, no! Oh, that was tough!
This is the real trauma core.
Yeah.
Hey, fuck best of five format.
Yeah, now we're here. Oh, man.
I'm banging at the doors of Esports Arena saying, Vi, please let me run fucking best of three stride, for God's sake.
Okay, wait, which Peachon killer is the one that we ping? Okay, it's the one with the chicken. Okay. There's two Peachon killers in the Discord, and I don't know if that's just the same guy with two Discord names, or...
I would hope so, because, taking someone else's tag like that is extremely rude.
There's two Shines from New York that enter WNF every week.
They really do need to do that money match. That would be really funny.
There's also Shine in SoCal, but I think it goes by Sheena more than Shine.
Alright, so we got Dog and Peachon Killer on here. The Peachon Killer won WNF like 2 or 3 weeks ago, right? Like, Hirsch was really the only one that was able to, like, maybe contest the run. And Hirsch isn't here today. Okay, so Peachon Killer. Oh, Zappa! Okay.
Oh boy, okay.
Alright, so this is still a matchup that we don't get to see a whole lot.
Yeah, particularly Zappa.
Yeah.
Except for Zappa Week, which did happen like once.
Yeah. Yeah, it's just that like Hellsap and the rest of the Zappa players don't show up that often, so I don't really get to see this. But, alright, so Stooges are already trying to lock Slayer in the corner, but Slayer is just gonna fucking BDC. Slayer doesn't have to hold any of that shit. He can just leave.
Probably not, but does have to hold Tyrant Rave, as I discovered once.
Everyone has to hold Tyrant Rave. Just go
get
a bit. Alright, so Sword's out. Sword is usually the best thing that Zappa can have, besides Rao, and even then, you know, I think most Zappa players still want Sword. Okay. Gets Stooges out again, but then takes a hit. Okay. We're not blocking that. Okay. Alright, we have Dog. I always associate the Dog with Aze devs. Okay. Dog is out again. I think it's really fucked up that Zappa can get like a round winning ghost for getting knocked down.
Yeah. But, Force Break Mappa stuff is real good.
Yeah. We're holding all of this. Peachon does not care about any of it and is going to make Dog hold all of it. So.
Player is not exactly easy to hold, and when you don't hold, here comes all the damage!
I never noticed that Sharon's colors change in these palettes. I don't think they did that in Exert, did they?
I don't think so.
Okay. Alright. Good patience here. Or at least trying to be patient, right? There's only so much you can do when you're holding Slayer Mash. Full air combo to the corner. Ooh! Alright.
Nice!
Okay.
Unfortunately, you still have to go with figure out how to deal with the rest of what Slayer's up to.
So, if I remember correctly, again, like, the main drawback to Dog is that he stays where he is. He can't be recalled easily. Looks like we have Rao on deck. Oh no! Can't get poked out.
And Dandy beats DP.
Ooh, good run.
Ooh, going out of that.
Okay, getting touched, immediately losing sword, not able to take any mileage out of that. Okay, getting it back. Ooh, yeah, that would be a great time to go in. Oh no, okay. Mappa. Okay. Oh man, I don't know what was going on, if like Dog just like gave up there, because he didn't block any of those last ones. But Pichon takes it.
That was fast.
Yeah. Slayer is just built different. Jeez.
Okay. The original Nagu damage output.
Yeah. Alright, so Pichon moves on 2-0. And we're almost ready to start Winner's Quarters. I think there's only one set left that needs to be reported, right?
Yeah, I think so.
This double DQ.
Yeah, Jason Ryan and Sheen Blade double DQ'd, which I guess just means that Jason didn't bother checking into his round one!
Like always?
Even though he's here right now! Jason.
I attempted to just leave it like that.
Yeah, no, just leave it. I want it to stay, because it moved on the correct player to Winner's Quarters anyway. So just leave it. Just let it be known that Jason Riot doesn't listen to his tournament organizers. Just have that.
After how many tournaments it has been?
Yeah. After how many tournaments has he won, especially, right?
Well, yeah.
Good job, Jason. The people's hero. Alright, so...
Especially whenever he does a Grand Viper,
yeah.
Or just a Raw Tyrant Rave. I want to see more Raw Tyrant Raves. I really want to see more Raw Tyrant Raves. People get hit by Factor Tyrant Rave off of just, like, Gun Flames.
Yeah.
Gunflame Factor Tyrant Rave just somehow works.
I mean, like, you have to hold that, right? You're just stuck there.
Oh, yeah.
And a lot of people try to up back out of, like, soul block strings. I realized.
You can, like, jump out of between the Gunflame and the Fafnir, but if I see you jump out, I don't actually have to do the time wave.
Alright, so let's see.
And of course, you have to, like, measure it with, like, Gunflame Volcanic Viper is always a thing, too.
Yeah, there's so much that you have to deal with.
I will do every stupid option, and you will have to respect every single one of them.
Okay, I've seen that Jacob Pat and Lohara are reporting the scores right now. So once they're done with that, okay. So it's good. So next on stream, we're gonna have Jason and Julio. Julio's already here. Julio is gonna be playing Jam, I guess. And then.
So it's like what we did, but it's people who actually know what they're doing.
So this is a matchup that we see on the Light the Iron Man stream all the time. This not in bracket. My losers match is playing DBFZ. Yeah, Wagner, Sheenblade always forgets to check into our bracket and never shows up. He got DQ'd out of round one and he's doing something else, so I just went ahead and DQ'd him again. But I moved the one to this round two, Wagner. He's very consistent about not showing up to any of Guilty Gear. He registers for WNF every week, like clockwork, and then he just doesn't show up. Alright, so I will... let winners round two know that they can play.
This is real fast.
I feel like I should know who Shinblade is based on, like, people talking about him.
Yeah.
But, people having just... never actually seen him play, because he never actually shows up to our tournaments that he registers for, yeah. I have no context for him whatsoever.
Especially if he's streaming other games that aren't Guilty Gear, you're not going to know anything about how well he is in Guilty Gear, so...
Yeah, it's true.
Okay.
Why is it that the weeks I'm not here, like, so interesting? This is irritating. I would have liked to seen, like, someone extremely unusual have won the whole thing.
Yeah, maybe you should give up playing Magic, I guess. That's the sign.
That's never gonna happen. That lifestyle has been seared into my soul.
Have you been playing Master Duel with everybody?
No, I don't like Yu-Gi-Oh. I really don't like Yu-Gi-Oh. I like when my games have, like, costs.
Yeah, which Yu-Gi-Oh doesn't have, right? Like, Yu-Gi-Oh is...
Wait, what?
Yeah, so you... Okay, oh, yeah, so have you... You've never played Yu-Gi-Oh then, Kim?
Yeah, I don't know shit about Yu-Gi-Oh.
Okay, so...
Well, Magic.
So you know that Magic and Pokemon and everything else, like, all the popular games, like Wizards of the Coast stuff, they all have costs to playing cards, right?
Right, you have, like, the energy cards or whatever.
Yeah, Yu-Gi-Oh has no card costs, which means...
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
So you kind of just do whatever?
Yeah.
Theoretically, you're supposed to sacrifice monsters to get stronger monsters, but it also really doesn't work that way, either.
Yeah, so...
That's fascinating.
So
what a cursed game.
Yeah, so...
Also, there's about a bajillion tutors for this, that, or another thing, and, also, infinite card advantage, and... I have a lot of problems with the game. Bridget! Okay.
Yeah, okay.
Not Jam.
Yeah. They were queued up
Maybe Julio fears the Grand Viper.
Yeah, I feel like Jam would do better against Soul.
No. Bridget can be a total pain.
Well, right now it looks like Jason's really comfortable with this.
I mean, it's Jason, yes, but like, I feel like Bridget can make Soul's life a lot harder than Jam can. Just generally on the toolkit.
Julio is a good. I've played against Julio's Bridget also. I guess this is Bridget night, and Jacob Pan and Julio are both playing Bridget. But
I'm fine with them boy play this.
Yeah, this is
really... This is the Bridget irritating time right here.
Oh, okay.
But
yeah.
Jeez.
Jason manages to just dash in and get there.
Yeah.
It probably doesn't help that I basically can't see the jump.
Alright, so here we go. Looking a little bit more comfortable here. I mean, round one was still close. Finally spending burst. Grand Viper's underneath Roger.
Roger is irritatingly extra plus all the time.
Okay, Fafnir.
Did not follow the time wave.
Ooh, okay.
Okay.
Oh, Tex out! Probably too light or small for the real combo. Alright, we're just gonna run and jump in and land, then DP to take.
I've been
one.
Doing that one a lot more lately. The jump, just yeah. Jump in and DP thing.
I don't know why it works, because there's landing lag and shit. Like, you should get hit! Like.
But also, you can just, like, DP just before you land, and it just.
It just works. Yeah, I... Fucking volcanic viper. Fuck you.
What a privileged move.
Alright, so... Jason really does not want to fight Julio. He wants this tank obliterated. Okay.
Has not gone clean hit Grand Viper at all. Disappointed.
Yeah.
Mash harder.
Okay, just like, just a falling sidewinder on the tech
map. That's
mash.
Clean hit and counter hit.
Yeah.
Not that matters, but hey.
Okay, wall throw, one, Two? Okay,
just
second
two.
One didn't, yeah.
Oh, Anthro.
Yeah. You can tell that, like, Jason Ryan is improvising a lot of stuff that he knows is going to work, but
yeah.
He also knows that a lot of this shit is dropping and he's very frustrated by it.
It's okay, he still got the perfect.
Yeah, so Jason Ryan moves on to winter semis.
Yeah, comboing bridges is kind of weird sometimes. Or at least, because what it is that, like, getting the good hit on bridges is really hard.
Yeah.
Like, you get, like, you can pick up, like, some minor stuff, but getting, like, the really, really juicy, like, starters is not easy. Because,
yeah.
Like, you want Soul, like, Soul wants to stall all of his combos on the ground and then move up, whereas...
Yeah,
whereas,
Bridget's
like,
already in the air.
Already
yeah.
Up there,
yeah.
So you can't really do that much.
Alright, so we have Stone here. Stone was filling for Tux during top eights after he got eliminated, so we're familiar with him on the mic and we're familiar with him in bracket. Effervescent Johnny player, and then Jacob Path, unless there's any other surprises, is going to be another Bridget. So
another one back from like 3 weeks ago when I was last here.
Yeah. So tonight is Femboy Hooters night. We're hope you enjoy the show. I don't actually know if I can make that joke.
You already did it, so, yeah.
Welcome to Wednesday Night Fights. Be sure to check out the match arena.
Hey, this is no less professional than any other plus.
All
this just
like,
comes with the territory,
a lot
man.
Of other tournaments, apparently.
Yeah. Alright, so we know Jacob Pat is here. Right? Okay, we're still just waiting on him. Okay, there he is. Oh! Testament! What? Whoa!
Ooh, okay. Okay.
Yeah, okay. Unless there's a change in something. Okay, so... What's the deal? So, Naj apparently also has a Bridget, too. So what's the deal with Bridget and Testament? Why...
I don't know.
Okay, so we get Jacob Pat Testament... I mean, Stone is no stranger to this matchup.
Cause, Jice, do you randomly also have a testament for some reason? Cause it seems you need to pick one up.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure that I've played against Jacob Pat's Bridget when I was, like, a player in WNF. And I've also played against it before just on Quick Play. Like, I'm 90% sure that it's the same dude. But it looks like...
Stone got a couple real nice, dead angles to start things off. They both just need one more solid, like, conversion here. That should do it. Oh, bust! But, immediately got hit after that.
Alright, so we're getting started again with Exabeast. We're gonna carry Stone to the corner. Three webs. Oh, this character's so fucked. I do like the trans white's colors though. Okay. It's finer putting.
Also has some real silly things there.
Ooh, cold burst.
Damage. Yeah.
What are we gonna do with it? Okay.
Oh!
We're gonna kill Jacob with his. What we're gonna
with
do with it?
Super Miss Finer. Hardly ever see that in Miss Finer, really.
Yeah.
Cause, like, I don't think you can combo off of it, really. It just does its big damage and that's it.
Yeah.
Which is not actually as much damage as what you can get off of level 2.
Alright, so dashing through. Already burning 2 coins for nothing. Well, I mean, I guess it's good to always throw the coins out.
Dashed into the skull.
has to spend both.
Supposed to get out of the X and B's mix up. Which I will never block as well.
Yeah. Alright. Oh, X and B's, unfortunately for Jacob, pushes the stone out of the corner. But we know how to put him back in there.
Raven helping a good amount here.
Yeah. We just need a couple more hits. Okay. Dick jabbed
Punish
to close
the
it out.
Blocked misfire there.
Alright, sweep.
Oh, whiff the bust.
Yeah. Really great punish there. Like, that was an incredible bait with the Exit Beast webs. Yeah, this is looking more like business as usual for Testament.
Yeah. Happened again!
Yeah.
Well, the Exodus knocked out of the tree.
Dagger. Alright, more. Oh, what the? Wow!
Dead angle went the wrong way, but got a throw anyway.
Oh, man. That's one of the frustrating things about blocking Testament mix, is that it turns the character around due to the really fucked up cross-up protection in this game.
The back Exodus turns you around, yeah, even though you're blocking, like, the right way.
Yeah. Oh, boy. Alright, so, game three, last game of the set. I mean, against Naj, this usually goes back and forth as well. So... Okay, bar in Senga to just like, before landing, not even wanting to deal with these traps. Okay.
Only 6H is just really good against Testament overall. Because that's been like the big tool that Jake, that Stone's been using.
Yeah.
Trying to start things off. Meanwhile, not blocking any of the Exodus mix, so
yeah.
Jacob gets that round.
There's also not much like he could have done there, right? Like, was he gonna do dead angle wrong in the wrong direction again? Like,
yeah. Well, apparently you just get a throw off of that if you dead angle in the wrong direction.
Yeah, that's also true. If you're like Sky and you keep mashing 4H or whatever after. Oh man. I don't know if you saw that, but, like, Irene posted, like, a clip of, like, a replay between her and Sky. And, like, Sky is just landing with Amelia in the input, like, in the input history, it's just full of 4-H. Like, from
that
top to the bottom of the screen.
Sky.
Yeah.
Alright. Please don't expose my input history. Actually, you already have.
Yeah, we all already have... exposed your input history on this call. Alright, so Jacob Pat takes it 2-1.
Testament continues to be Testament.
Yeah.
And Jacob Pat's really good with them.
Yep. Alright, so winner's side of top 8 has now been sorted out. So these next sets will all be on stream. Loser's side of top 8, which is loser's round 3, is going to be... winner of Stone and Wagner versus winner of Joe Fish and Mercy, and winner of Saison versus Tails versus Julio. So, while we wait for the winner's side to just get sorted out, first of all, check out the Matcherino. Mubot posts it sometimes. Exclamation mark Matcherino. There aren't a whole lot of us in here. I mean, I'm assuming the people that are watching normally are also the people who usually play, so they're also at Frosty. But, you guys should redeem those codes, so that Jason can afford a hat. And, in the meantime...
If Jason wins tonight, that means that he gets a bounty on him, right?
Yeah.
That'll be good. We haven't had one of those for a while. I like drawing those things.
Yeah, everyone likes your art too.
It's true. Yeah, it's really I'm good. Kind of flabbergasted by it, yeah. But.
So in the meantime, so while loser side gets sorted out, we'll get Jason versus I think Tip Me.
Yes.
Okay, Tip Me.
Neat.
Yeah. So Jason versus Soul Cliff, right? So.
Yeah, I don't know what. Cliff still befuddles me a lot. How do you combo the guy? How do you hit the guy?
Yeah.
It's so small.
Tip me Nightcorvers?
I love when I try and Bandit Winger and like it just doesn't. Or whatever.
Yeah. Listen, he's got osteoporosis. He's very old.
Alright, yeah, so here we go. So, I mean, ideally, if Jason Rai gets in, he can probably crank stun in, like, really quickly, but, yeah, Cliff has wonky hitboxes, sidesteps, stuff like that, so might be really hard to actually hit him if Tipmy knows what he's doing, and Tipmy certainly does.
Gold bust!
Yeah. I'm pretty sure you can FRC that drill, or cancel it early, or something, yeah, so... Alright, here we go.
Throw, yeah!
Three. Or no, two. Okay, black
just
beat
three.
And then three. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, comboing the guy is weird. I feel like Cliff doesn't really have that many, like, really good ways to use, tension and neutral, which is why.
Yeah. He spends it all on stuff like that, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so we're back to playing neutral with fireball and taunt. Back dashing.
Like, I can't remember if Cliff has like a really messed up force break, like most other characters do.
Yeah, I imagine. I feel like I've seen him like do something where he like okay he did a red room cancel there to cancel it.
Oh, baited the bust out block, and Jason, of course, has the great punish for it.
Alright, we're doing some Tekken combos. Uh-oh.
You know what's rude?
Huh.
Grand Viper does not low profile the drill.
Oh no, did we desync detected? Are they still playing? Oh, okay. Looks
they are like playing. I'm seeing it. What?
Okay.
Jason went into IK mode, doing Jason things, I guess.
Oh. You're gonna have
it's
to give
definitely
us.
Definitely getting got by it.
You're gonna have to give us the radio play-by-play. I got kicked back to the room, and I don't see Tip Me in here.
Okay. Wild throw one. This time just doing a, dodge a 5D with the, parry thing. But yeah, after the first, Sidewinder combo didn't really work, I think Jason decided to, not really try.
I see.
Although now he's got one with full Sidewinder, so maybe it's just like a matter of where the situation.
Okay. What's the round count right now?
A 1-1.
Okay. I don't know what happened here, folks. Oh boy.
Let's start as a website.
Yeah.
Yeah. This is the grounded footsies game Guilty Gear that we all know and love.
Alright.
So, Bandit Revolver apparently does not really work properly on Cliff, among other things.
Uh-huh.
Because Jason did like 2P, 2D Bandit Revolver, and the Bandit Revolver whiffed and when I think that probably would have hit any other character.
Okay, so it looks like Tipmy did get kicked out. Okay, according to the room, Jason won that. So I'll put that on here. I'll mark that. Okay, he's back.
Jason did win.
Okay.
Also, personally, see Tipmy's previous cost name.
Yeah.
I don't know why it is that I see a different name than you consistently for a lot of the players.
Alright, well, I don't know if the, if he can't ready up or whatever. I'll remake the room.
I don't see a ping for him, so...
Yeah. That probably means he's, like, taking a bajillion years to load in or something. Alright, so I'm gonna remake the room real quick. In fact, I'm gonna go a little further than that. I'm just gonna completely restart plus R, so just give me a minute, folks. It does look like in the meantime we have one half of Loser's Top 8 sorted out. So it looks like it's going to be Tails versus Julio. In the meantime, I'm going to get the room sorted out again here. Create room. Set it to random. Alright, Alright, so I have remade the room. Right now, set count is 1-0 in Jason's favor. Hopefully, they don't crash out of the room this time. Don't know what happened there.
Life is so good.
Yeah.
Speaking of which, Baikin!
Oh, yeah.
I'm excited for Baikin.
Yeah, tonight. She actually does look interesting. I don't know if I'm going to play her, but she does look interesting. I
get got by the counter every time.
Yeah.
I know this.
Yeah, hey, it's really fucked up that she doesn't have to pick the height anymore.
No!
Yeah. Like it just parries all heights. I think it's frame one.
You have to fucking melt the blood shield.
Yeah.
It's like a start of your life for some reason because it's drive.
Yeah. Yeah, she has like.
Either like yeah. Before with like there's like a buddy of mine who's big into Viking that plays like Anji. Before.
Yeah.
And so like when those 50 meter I'd be like, okay, now I need to respect.
Why did Tipmy pop IK there?
Oh.
He wants to kill him, I guess.
Well, I mean Jason did pop IK.
Did it work?
My goodness. In the previous round and
okay.
Died for it.
Well,
that makes sense.
Jason has a tendency to pop IK randomly anyway, though.
Yeah, or taunt randomly, or...
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, that follow-up on Volcanic Viper just not working.
Oh,
yeah.
God.
What a character.
Okay. Oh no, just throw the burst.
Threw the burst!
Okay.
Also...
Yeah,
Bandit
just
Winger greater than
the Dragon Slayer super. Yeah,
I think Dragon Slayer is the other one.
Or whatever this one is with the teeth.
Yeah.
So many teeth. Alright, so very, very goofy cartoon character.
I also learned that, the Bandit Bringo is greater than Talent Wave Omega.
I don't know why. Like, I don't know why. It sucks. I hate that. Alright, so anyway, so it looks like Jason moves on.
I think that's actually more of like a timing spacing thing. Cause I've gone got by Omega on my Bandit Bringo before.
Alright, and now
mostly by Zorka.
Peach on the Jacob Pap. Coming on stream.
Testament Slayer.
Yeah, it's gonna be another set where like either Slayer gets successfully locked down or like the
Does Slayer get to play the game?
Yeah. And if he does, then just big bang upper through that twink.
Yeah.
There's like no contest.
Big bang upper the Badlands? That sounds sweet. Yeah.
Alright, so here we go. Alright. Let's do this. Heaven or hell? Duel. One, let's rock! Alright, immediately. Oh, okay. The burst. Yeah. Does a decent job at also clearing out the webs and stuff. Alright, both
Wong
bursts.
Gets punished.
Okay.
2H better than Dandy Step. Okay. Wong's the Mappa Punch.
Okay, slide. Oh, cross-ups.
Just want to get out of there and not deal with the Dandy anything.
Right.
These Dandy moves are just whiffing.
Ooh, there we go. Okay, you have to press a button there and you're going to get caught by the web if you press.
Yeah.
Okay. Burst is almost on the... What was that web above the burst icon? Did you see that?
Yeah.
When did he put that there?
Ages ago, apparently.
Oh, God. Okay.
Oh, another early burst.
Yeah, Exabeast catches the BDC.
But this time, the Power Bunker nips him a little bit, and that's big damage.
Yeah. This is a Slayer round for sure.
Yeah. Burst. Probably not worth using.
Yeah. Ooh!
RC throw?
Yeah, FRC warranted the throw, and then... Okay, maybe Jacob Pack can still do this. Definitely wants to hold down to that burst.
Warren actually had an FRC point.
It looked like that was Warren. I don't actually know if it was. But...
I think actually Pishon did the RC on some.
Oh, okay. And then Jacob. No, don't burst there!
Use the.
Okay, he FRC'd Undertow, and then he got thrown, right? Okay.
Yeah.
And it couldn't, a lot of stuff going on screen there.
Yeah, because the Slayer attention was went down that time.
Okay, here we go. Again.
Just barely outranges these Mappas.
Yeah.
Just don't want to deal with them. 2H again, being that option now.
Yeah. Another...
Now Slayer time.
Yeah. Another situation where you have to block Exabeast and then
blocks
you get crossed up.
The Eternal Wings and Punish is gets punished for it.
Tree.
Okay, cuss.
Yeah, there we go.
Yeah.
Just one more touch. Oh no.
Ooh.
Oh jeez! That force break. Okay. Oh man! Ooh. Robbery!
Wow. That was whack.
Yeah.
The teleports, like, FB will always get me.
Yeah, that was something and a half.
Whiffs the bus and gets caught by the Exit Beast on the way down? Okay. Could not convert off the tree and net there. Okay. Might not have been expecting it, really.
Bust the stun.
Key.
Yeah, hold all this.
Okay. Ooh!
Yeah. Great punish on that.
Tried to envil through the Exit Beast, but US gets it.
Oh no, no 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 no.
Uh-oh. Looks like another slayer round so far, but here's a chance. It angles out. Throws the dandy. Blackbeat into Key Super.
Trade.
Oh, tree. Now I'm poisoned. Wheel ticking down.
No burst on deck for Peachon either, which means Peachon either does something like that!
Oh, just does that V-Pile Bunker twice! Exit Beast is just a really good answer to the dandy step.
Yeah. But then Peachon was just like, I'll fucking do it again, and then he just like he's like, eventually mashing through the set play will work. And I'm okay with that.
I mean, when I'm playing against Testament, I'm like, I will not respect any of this, because if I try to respect it, I'm just playing into what you want me to be doing.
Yeah. That is unfortunately a really good way of looking at it. Okay. Once again, this is a similar situation to game one. Okay.
This time got the conversion and hit.
Yeah. Alright, so here we go.
The 2H invul frames just being out the...
Oh, that was
the power driver.
Fucked up looking clash.
Yeah.
6P.
So much damage. Why does Slayer do this much damage?
This is just fucked up. This is a fucked up game.
But then Testament just says you will stay in this corner for all of eternity.
I don't know why Peachon is making me root for the Testament player here, honestly. He's just making Slayer look fucked up. Okay. Good block. Oh no, didn't got crossed up. Set point. Okay, here we go.
Okay, one connects, poison ticking down.
Okay, that back dashes out after blocking the first hit. Can you convert off of there?
Poison conversion there.
Okay. Oh no, Brad Burst!
End up not getting really punished for it though. But kinda did because ended up in this bad situation because of it.
Yeah.
And Peachon gets go on.
That was much closer than it looked. But yeah, so now it's gonna be Jason Riot Peachon Killer Winners Finals. We're not gonna have that yet, though. We're going to have... Did Stone and Wagner finish playing their set? I see Stone reported...
I really want to see Time Wave stuffing a backdash. I really want to see that.
Okay, so in the meantime, so Stone has to... Okay, so Stone has to report the next set. I'm assuming that Stone won against Wagner to move on to Losers Round 3, aka Top 8, against Joe Fish. And, well, I mean, I can probably just fix that on our own. And then on the other side is going to be Tails versus Julio Rivera. I guess I'll get Tails and Julio on here while we sort out the little scoring bit. So let's see. Tails are gone.
Angie Bridget.
This will be interesting to see. This is another set that we don't really see a whole lot.
Feel like they like Bridget here, just because I'm not sure if Bridget really cares about Fujin.
Yeah, you're probably, like, flying over a lot of these guard points, right?
Yeah.
I also don't know if, like Roger might ignore them, just straight up.
I think Roger doesn't totally ignore them, but, like, what are you gonna do with the guard point, really, when you're guard pointing Roger, but Bridget's way over there?
Yeah, exactly. Alright, so Julio is here. Tails is here. Let me see, I'll flip this around. There we go.
I do have to say that Tails very firmly passed the Grand Viper check. In the, like, one and only time I've played him before.
Meaning what, like at round start?
No. Just in generally, like, blocking low.
Ah, okay.
And not just like letting Grand Viper just stuff Fujin for free.
Heaven or hell. Two, one, let's rock.
They got the Fujin, but didn't get much of a follow-up on it. This time got the own.
Okay. Oh no.
As long as Anji can actually, like, stay on Bridget, then, it looks pretty good for Anji.
I think that... Okay, here we go. We're working our way back out.
Yeah, now we're in the Bridget just... Ooh, guard points. I feel like, once Bridget got away, like, he should just stay away and not let... Not challenge any of Anji's stuff.
Whoa. What? Oh!
Okay, full on conversion there.
Oh man. Okay, that was just...
That was very decisive.
Yeah, that was just it. Okay, so...
Does Julio, like... know this matchup or not? I'm not sure. It does seem like a weird matchup to learn.
Yeah, like we haven't seen it, so...
No!
You know, I wonder.
Cause like, it's very possible that Julio just plays an aggressive Bridget by like, basic playstyle, but I don't see that being correct in this matchup. I can see that when Julio runs away more, that things just generally go better.
Alright, we're holding the Anji mix.
It's about a 2k, but the jump made them whiff.
Okay, more wall bounce. Okay, wake up DP. Finally getting to play a little bit. Crosses themselves up. But okay. Oh, okay, so that did beat Fujin.
Yep.
But we're gonna
Fujin is only upper body anvil, not lower body anvil. Hence why Grand Viper beats it.
I like that that's your frame of reference for everything. Does Grand Viper beat this move?
Yes.
No? Okay, let's go back to the fucking drawing board. Anyway, Tails just kind of immediately blew through Julio there to move on. So we're going to see Tails versus Jacob Pat in Loser's Quarters. In the meantime, on the other side of top 8, we'll get Joe and Stonefish. I actually said that on purpose, but she wouldn't be able to tell. They're fish more like go fish. Yeah, so Stone's already here, so. Moving through the bracket really quickly. Even Chad doesn't remember whether or not Fujin is strike or throw involved.
According to Dustloop, H Fujin is 1 through 12 frame strike invul.
Okay, there we go.
Yes, but also has a really high hitbox.
Heaven or hell? Duo, one, let's rock!
Alright, so. More Anji pressure. I mean,
Anji, yeah.
This is gonna be different than what we saw before. I mean, obviously Anji has great reversal tools or great defensive tools, but this is Johnny. So.
Johnny has a really good 6H. Jay got double Fujin into On. Into the Oki. Dead angles out there.
Uzis.
Uzi.
Oh, not nothing. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah, good burst punish.
Yep.
Okay. Point goes over. I just like these jump overs. We're gonna get a bit mileage. Okay, checks out. looking dangerous for Joe, though.
Okay, Invol's through the 6-H there. The Fujin, but didn't get much off of it.
Yeah, I'm flying across the screen.
It has connect twice, and that's that.
Alright, yeah, so Stone, more decisive in round 3 there. Immediately getting counter hit with the coin, so we immediately eat this Misfinder shit. Okay.
Back of sight, yeah. Unblockable Misfinder.
Yeah, forced to burst out, well, but took 50% for a round start interaction gone wrong.
Full Jack Hound stuff, and God. That's perfect.
That was the beginning of the game.
Yeah.
This is fucked up. Stone, calm down. Okay, Stone.
What?
Yeah. Stone has a grudge against the Anji players, it seems. Okay, not a double perfect.
Okay, not a double perfect. But pretty darn close to
Christ!
One.
That was one hit. Yeah. Joe officially got one hit that entire game, too. No! Hey! No, they finished it. They finished the set. Stone won. This is... I don't know what this is. This is the...
No more Guilty Gear.
Anji! I like Anji's... The Anji thing. With the fan of the head. That's perfect.
Alright, so...
What happened?
I don't know.
Just whipped the IK because it doesn't work point blank?
I guess fucking not, huh?
Like that?
Alright.
Dragon has bigger hitbox.
Yeah, Stone allows Joe Fish to get the run back.
Whereas, like, Napalm Death doesn't work unless you're point blank.
Alright, in the meantime, we will move
on. I've seen enough wise IK subs in Exod. Like, there's no struggle. I have no sympathy for the struggle.
Zwei is like lab that shit out, but Zwei also makes that shit look mad easy. Your character is good in another game. I don't like dealing with this character. Zwei has ruined like my perceptions of Johnny for life.
The only character with every IK in this game is just like cussed somehow, except for like Kai's. Like Kai's is normal.
Yeah.
It's like just a regular far slash in basically.
I would do like GMIK in Exerd as a habit after learning how to play plus R, and it would work in Exerd because even with the increased like IK like stance startup, like the IK itself was just already fast, so it's like I'll just do it when you're stunned. Jeez. Got him.
Even I'm gonna mash out of that stuff. You know this.
Yeah.
You did it.
Yeah. I did.
Sometimes
do
it. It's really an unexpected buff in Exod that they moved Dragonstall from S to H.
That was like the worst thing that I've ever done to somebody in this game, or like in Guilty Gear as like a whole, was I IK'd Bacon and Eggs in the Mild West bracket on stream. And then I clipped it after.
Heel shit.
It's okay. Heavy Mob Cemetery definitely needs a god point.
fuck you. Why does that work? It's one thing if it's like invincible, right? If it's one thing to have like an invincible super, like okay, invincible supers, those are fucked up. Whatever. Like, Megalomania being invincible is fucked up, but whatever. But, like, the fact that the guard point continues...
It's so fucking funny.
Yeah.
Next clip I put in Mighty meme a while back, where it's just, like, the glueless unloading the machine gun at him mid Heavy Mob Cemetery is fucking beautiful.
I still really, really want to Heavy Mob Cemetery Calvados. Like, I really want that.
Yeah, next time we have a lobby, we should really definitely try to orchestrate that.
Yeah.
It's so funny.
And also, unlike Tyrant Rave, it's a super that you actually are able to do on player 2's side, so you know, anything can happen.
Hey, I don't need to do Tyrant Rave. At least in plus all, I get the better Tyrant Rave.
Yeah, for like easy off the easier input, you piece of
easier
shit.
Easier input and also cheaper.
Yeah. I don't know why he can do that, but alright, so...
Yes, it is Testament time.
Yeah, so...
Welcome to the blender that is Testament.
Oh, man.
Ah.
Okay, finally throwing out of Exabeast, but, I mean... Okay.
Fujin just knocking away the net is nice.
This is like an,
Okay, multi-mix up.
This is like a gorilla in a hurricane. That's like the best way that I can describe this, because like you have to, if Anji manages to block everything successfully, he's just gonna Fujin all over. Okay.
Yeah, but not quite everything. Pretty close though.
All right, here we go. More shenanigans.
Say, Fujin?
Okay, yeah, keep blocking that shit.
The Fujin beat the tree as well.
Whoa.
Wrong direction.
Yeah. Okay, now we're kind of getting something started. Okay, no, but warrant side switches. Yeah, what a good reversal.
Okay. This combo. Wow.
Barely enough to kill. Oh! Okay.
Oh! It did kill.
Yeah.
But that was really close.
I think barely had enough meter there to end that like that and show off. Okay, there we go. Around the world. Okay, Fujin threw the blocking the tree in time too. I didn't even remember that was there. Okay. Probably an unfavorable trade. Dead angle has been burst in order to not get mixed again. But
Tails hasn't been using mean at all. It's only been fourth break.
Yeah.
Oh no, Nagi. It hasn't been using Nagi. It's only been fourth break green.
Yeah.
Like fourth break green is really excellent and all, but like maybe something else.
There's probably like. He probably doesn't think that he can get that mix. He doesn't want to be maybe in like an unfavorable position after using Nagiha instead.
That's fair.
I wouldn't really know. Does Nagiha also like? I guess I'll look it up later. Yeah. All right. Okay, so we start again. Oh, okay. Tried the Fujin under the skull, but gets hit by it anyway because he gets counter hit on what comes next. Okay, black beat, but we're gonna take that reset. Okay. Interesting, like, fake unblockable cross up. Okay. Again!
He
needs
Fujin
to...
through again,
yeah.
But still didn't work. The Exabeast got there.
Yeah, he needs to be a little bit more careful when he sees objects.
Yeah.
Okay. Looks like that was three reps, and then...
Yep.
Okay, unblockable time! You know, fun fact, Anji had free unblockable butterfly in a version of Strive that was before OBT2. Yeah, there was, like, gameplay footage of Anji from before OBT2 where he had butterfly.
Fujin just beating through, Gravedigger. I did want to see that. That was kind of on my bingo card today.
Oh, he got the ID, but he didn't get the full combo. Whoa. Whoa.
Delay the Fujin a bit. But maybe get hit by the close slash if he delays. So it's like, you just gotta hold it. Holding a testament is certainly not what you want to be doing, really.
Hits Jacob out of like his air setup, and then puts Jacob back into the corner. And this could be it. Yeah.
Setup there, but whiffed the dust, but got the round anyway, and the game.
Yeah, there we go. We even up the game count. Looking a lot less dangerous for Tails right now. Okay, we're gonna keep it going.
Heaven or hell, duel. One, let's rock. The ring got there. Late regular ring.
Yeah.
Tried to jump in with a bun, but the X and B still clipped them.
Okay, burst at the correct part of the XB's cross up. Still gets hit after.
Pop it. Yeah, Fujin is just not functioning as an answer to that situation.
Oh boy. Okay. Unfavorable trade. Jacob's on set point.
Throwing poison.
Oh no!
Jumps the Ixabeast, which is pretty okay. Fujin's through the net.
Okay, here we go. Yeah. Alright, more Fujin pressure. Yeah.
Immediately bust the wand.
Yeah. I mean, you know, the more that he does it, the more that you pointed out, the more I kind of, like, understand and agree. He really is relying on Sheen exclusively. Not even the Force Break version, like, after Nagiha. Or after, like, Fujin.
Sheen is the,
Yeah, there we go.
Like, if you only use lean, then it's just so free to just keep blocking high in that situation.
Yeah, there's no low mix-ups, there's no, like, fan
toss. There's no throw mix-up with pop.
Yeah, so... I mean, again, maybe there's, like, something where he feels like maybe
Testament probably has, like, good options to stuff the other, like, other things, the way, like, in Strive, I can just, like... above 5k, and it'll beat everything but Nagiha.
Yeah. It's probably... It has to be like a matchup thing, or... Something happens where he either feels like maybe Testament can Abari out of it really well, or Testament already has traps, and those will get caught really well, or something, but... good stuff either way. All of our Anjis have now been eliminated from bracket. No more fans. No more only fans.
Suspicion is that something like how 5K, Soul 5K and Strive just like beats everything but Nagiha after Fujin.
Yeah. Stone. So next we'll get Stone versus Titmei, I believe. Scores here. So Stern's already back. I'm already in the process of adding him anyway. So, I believe we've seen this before.
I think we have.
So, we'll just see like who comes out on top this time. This probably looks like a lot less... Well, it probably looks a lot more volatile, actually, than the Soul Cliff matchup that we saw earlier, right? Like, Johnny doesn't have the same amount of, like, wild and randy and free tools that Soul does in order to, like, smack this old man around the screen. And...
Yeah, but Johnny does have 6H, and I think 6H is very good.
Yeah, that's also true. Oh, goodness! Oh, man, we're just braining this dude. Okay, fireball.
Just beating the coin out with a button.
Oh, okay. Good call out on the sidestep. Tippy had the read on the cross up, but Stone was just one step ahead. That was really good.
It looks like Cliff is just as hard to combo as usual, but Stone does get that with a level 3 misfind, though.
Yeah. And all it took was like one, like, big brain counter read.
Yeah.
Alright, here we go again. Stone feeling much more comfortable. Okay. Okay, that was kind of fancy. The sidestep of winning the coin.
Yeah. I mean, that's kind of good for Johnny because, like, the coin is not a high commitment.
Yeah. And, like, once he sees that, like Tippy's already locked into that defensive option.
Right.
So it's just like, alright, I'm just gonna...
Blocks the bust, and, gets the easy punish.
Alright, so here
and
we go.
Game one.
We're gonna keep going.
Does feel very knife edge, though.
Yeah.
Especially that first round, how that first round went.
Okay, taunt Oki. Good start. Good start for Tippy.
It's so funny how taunt's like an actual legit move in this pull for Cliff.
Yeah. You actually weren't here. You missed it when Pat and Joe Biden were playing against each other, and they were just throwing shurikens at each other. Go.
It's interesting how Tippy isn't trying to contest these like air-to-air type things, but maybe like Nsenga is just so scary in that situation.
Yeah.
In that regard,
I feel like Cliff has good grounded anti-airs, but like if Tippy's already in the air, there's probably not much you can do against Stone's buttons.
Like fighting against Cliff, I'm usually used to like JS and JH just like making you very upset. Yeah.
I'm used to that fake DP that he does where he waggles his sword just hitting me out of literally everything I try to do.
Yeah.
It's really frustrating.
Quinn interrupts the drill.
Yes. Stone's still down on health, but still feeling pretty comfortable here. Okay. Ooh, great reset. Builds. Oh, whiff.
Bakasai. Doesn't connect with it.
Reversal. Oh! Say my name. That didn't kill. What?
And then another super. But Stone has the resources here.
He just FRC'd that 3 times! Oh, whoa, my goodness.
That's all he is, one way to use the resources.
What a fucking, like, Popeye the Sailor Man ass set.
Yeah, and using N'Sanga to punish the bust.
Oh, man.
from the heavens. Death from above right there.
Oh, jeez. Alright, so Stone's gonna move on to Loser Semis. We'll see that later, but it's gonna be the run back against Jacob Pat, who put Stone into Losers in the first place. In the meantime, we're gonna get Winner's Finals, which is gonna be Best of Five, which is gonna be Jason Ryan versus Pichon Killer, and, if anyone can, stop...
I really, really want to see... the backdash get stuffed by Tyrant Wave. I really want to see it. I also want to see a lot of Grand Vipers. I think Grand Vipers like legit really good in the matchup.
Well,
because it tends to beats like Dandy Step and Mappa Punch really cleanly.
Those two. Yeah, I want to see this. If anybody could, like, stop Jason Riot from, winning, like, two in a row here, if anyone can stop the bounty from accruing, I have a feeling it would be Pichon. But likewise, I feel like if Jason Riot was here that week that Pichon Killer beat everybody up... Well, actually, Jason Riot got upset really early during that week, didn't they?
Yeah!
So,
yeah, I
saw that. I was like, wow, Jason got upset super early and just like gone.
Yeah.
Maybe the going to bed excuse was actually real then, and just gave out.
Yeah. So Jason's here waiting on Pichon. In the meantime, while we get this is, we're in, like, top four now, so in the meantime, be sure to check out that match right now, so that Jason can afford a hat. I believe both of these players are guaranteed top three, and they'll both benefit from the match arena payout, so, contribute! Use those codes, they're free.
Grand Viper, I love you, Jason.
He knows what the fans want. He's really got his finger on the pulse of the nation.
Okay. I guess Slayer's command grab is better than Soul's command grab. Proven
oh,
right
here
there.
We go. One. Oh, we're just catching it.
It's the fancy combo with Tyrant Wave.
God damn it.
Jason hasn't really done the real Tux Tyrant Waves though. I just wanna see him raw sometimes, so like after like as part of pressure.
Okay, Bloodsuck. Cross up. Oh, that whiffed!
Yeah!
That was just, like, too far. Okay. Alright, run up 5k, getting stuffed here by BDC. He just leaves.
Grand Viper did not get the clean hit, insufficient mash. Today, Jason's Grand Vipers have not been as, excellent as they
used. Alright, well, he's only started doing them because you told them to. So. Alright, just DP out, yeah.
VV's between the two hits of that, of the, Dandy Step move.
Alright, one.
Okay.
Okay, Black
Bust.
Beats, but we're okay with that, probably. Oh, this is actually really scary for both of these players.
Yeah!
Okay!
Oh, but Mappa Punch gets there.
Alright, tying it up.
Just the rush forward. blocked that. No one has blocked that tonight so far.
Yeah.
Table Kang Viper. Gunflame. You can't backdash through the Gunflame. Okay, fancy conversion for the Sidewinder.
Is he gonna do a third Gunflame FRC? No, he's gonna catch.
Nah.
There it was. Keyshawn is like floating around here. Oh, what? JH clashed with that?
JH is so dumb.
Why did that clash with Super?
Because it's JH. Hey, I've clashed Space Chicken with JH before.
Are you? I'm so mad. I need to go for I need to go for a walk. Okay, here we go again. Bichon starting off strong.
JP is a blessed move. Like most of Soul's moves.
Yeah, we're gonna catch the falling Slayer with. Okay. Slide. Yeah. He's at a stomp.
Just catch the stomp with another VV. What a privileged DP.
Big bang uppers.
Best DP in fighting games.
Yeah. You know, now that I've been playing a lot of BlazBlue, I feel like Naoto EX DP is probably up there.
Might be up there, but
It's certainly inspired by Volcanic Viper. It's definitely like taking a lot of cues from Soul.
I mean, it's inspired by the inspiration, by the thing that was inspired by Volcanic Viper.
Yeah, yeah, for sure.
Nah, Lifeway is my.
Alright. FRC Gunflame setups. Dust Loop. Great. Stop it!
Black Beat Sidewinder combo.
Oh my god.
Very Black Beat Sidewinder combo. Throws the Force Break.
Okay. Fucking JH to close it out again. What
JH
the
is so good.
Dude?
It also has zero recovery frames for some reason. Why? I don't know, but every game, zero recovery frames.
Yeah, I don't know why. Like, especially in, like, the Guilty Gear games that, like, have more prominent recovery, like, recovery frames on, like, landing, right? Like, plus R and Strive specifically, where they both, like...
Still zero.
Like, still zero. Like, I don't know what. Like, fuck you.
Hey, they gave Soul 3-frame 5k back.
Yeah, I don't know. Daisuke's...
They decided that was not good. That was too much for Exodus. But they gave it back to him and
tried. I'm gonna go to Daisuke's house. I'm gonna have a conversation with him.
They also made Fafnir plus 11 for some reason.
Yeah, I don't know why Fafnir guard crushes when it was minus 17 here. Like, well, I mean, effectively it was minus 17, but then you just fucking force break Tyrant.
It's just minus 6.
Right?
Yeah.
Yeah, so it's like.
It's minus 6.
fucking. Fuck Soul! Oh, I'm mad about.
See you in a top here.
Yeah. Okay. Okay,
oh,
yeah.
Well,
oh, what? He doesn't
get
the punish on...
But...
I as he was scared? Like, I don't know.
Well,
maybe
I'll
he saw
it.
That, like... Okay, there we go. Okay.
Jason's just, feeling himself here.
Okay, here we go. Oh, okay. Yeah, no.
He had
the meter. I thought that would. I've played enough Tux Dev to know that that would have been the thing that you would have immediately fucking gone for.
I absolutely would have done it because I always do it.
Okay.
The only reason for me to not time wave is if the Fafnir just completely whiffs.
No sloop. Dust Winder. Two. Three.
Three.
Dash out. Dash out didn't kill!
Oh,
okay, though,
OTG.
Okay. Oh, man. I wish that... I'll probably submit it next month. I'll save this clip for next month. Because SageJam Will It Kill is tomorrow, and he's probably done looking at clips. Oh,
yeah.
God.
Yeah, I threw all those Dark Souls clips in. There was one of them in there.
The ones that you showed us on the Might meme?
Yeah.
Well, oh, man.
Slayer can still do Slayer things, and takes that game.
Alright, here we go. So, yeah, so Pichon Killer, out but not down. I meant to say it that way, because... Stone lamenting. Oh my goodness! What fucking, like, what level of reactions are you on that you immediately, like, round start burst throw? Like, what?
That's just knowing, okay? That's not a reaction, that's just knowing.
Yeah, like... Like, Jason Riot is, like, is he fucking Neo? Like, I don't... Like, he plays, like, Jason is so fucking weird because he has, like, three personalities, right? He has the personality on Twitter that fucking shit... He has the Jason Riot has the personality on Twitter where he shitposts on all of his results screens. He has his personality in my chat where he pretends to be sleepy all the time. And then he has a personality in-game where he's just beating the shit out of you over and over. Oh, man. Alright, so anyway, set point for Jason.
5k's the dandy step.
A little black beat.
Okay. One more thing, big bang upper.
Resets. Oh
Jason
no!
All the resources are just air grabs.
Oh man. Okay. That was nuts. Okay, so Jason Ryan moves on to Grands. Peachon is going to be waiting for winner of Stone versus Jacob Papp in Loser Semis, which we'll get on stream right now. So, again, this is the run back. Jacob Papp put Stone into Losers. It was in a very close set. Yeah, I think that's a good way to put it. Like, they're all running in tandem. I guess it's time for you. I guess it's time for chat to read some RO7 light novels.
Yes, please read Kikonia When They Cry, a visual novel by acclaimed Dojin Circle 7th expansion. Very good. Also read Umineko When They Cry and Higurashi, etc., etc., etc.
I think Krieg endeared himself to you by having an Umineko themed profile.
You see, I'm like conflicted because on one hand, yes, but on the other hand, he's a zoner.
He also did hold up Bracket for like half an hour while his ISP died, although we can't really blame him.
That wasn't his fault,
yeah.
Bro.
SPs. Apparently, I'm supposed to be getting fiber soon. Like, in this neighborhood.
Oh, that'll be nice.
Yeah. I'll believe it when I
yeah.
it.
In the meantime, I'm stuck out here streaming the Loser Semis on Cursed Ass Spectrum. We'll randomly go out late at night sometimes.
Yeah, late, like the last 2 days, I've woken up at 4 a.m. in the morning. I'm like, I can't go to sleep. I'll just fool around the internet for an hour. And the internet's been out. I'm like, this is not okay.
Alright, so Jake and Pat, running more of the stuff that's going on. More of the same from the winner's side set. Alright. Oh my god, that cross up. Alright, so Jake and Pat takes game one. What's it gonna be? Stone feeling much more comfortable here. Clearly. Is that stun? Yeah, get his ass!
This is called home field advantage because they're on the main ship.
Yeah. Stone likes the stage. He leaves it on the default stage for Gone whenever he's good. It's also playing whatever the song is called, Drunkard, whatever.
Yeah.
Have you heard like the Guilty Gear X version of this song, like Guilty Gear X Advance? Like,
oh god,
like I don't know, like for whatever reason Daisuke really like cheaped out on like the sound chip for like the Game Boy Advance version of this game, so it sounds like
on the Game Boy Advance is not exactly the most
Game Boy Advance Pokemon games like sound decent, right? Like, you know, like you can, if you play cleverly, you can work well with what you have, and like Daisuke is like he knows this stuff, right? Like he's a professional musician. But like the GTX Advance sound chip sounds like a fucking it sounds like a Game Boy Pocket game. Like it sounds really bad.
That sound font? Yeah. That sound font will do that.
Alright, so Stone takes a game, evening the set count. The set was close on winner's side too, so Stone could absolutely do this and make it to top three, but
wherein Slayer awaits them.
Yeah, where Pichon Killer. Yeah.
Hence why his feel of no matter who wins, I lose.
Yeah.
You can get there. Yeah.
I believe in you, Stone. Don't make me feel bad for believing in you. Get his ass. Okay, you're not getting his ass.
Yeah, Testament is being Testament again.
Yeah, this is gonna be really tough. Okay, good dead angle.
Okay, dead angle. Another dead angle, and now we're back into the Testament mix.
Whenever Testament turns around in this palette, it looks like he has a bald spot. Alright, okay, not quite. Alright, set point for Jacob. Okay. Alright, has to burst. Yeah, super jump ID out. Pretty good option, all things considered. Especially considering that Jacob didn't actually set traps yet. But doing a little bit rough on the landing. Whoa. All Okay.
Testament 6P yeah. and overhead.
Oh no! Okay, he dead angled there, I think. But yeah. then he got hit by literally everything on the fucking planet. Alright, so yeah, good stuff. Drake and Pat double eliminating Stone. Stone did was like making it closer, but Jacob like had completely downloaded Stone throughout the bracket. It seems so.
Yeah.
All right. So Jacob Pat moves on to losers finals. So which means Jacob Pat stay here.
Thing is, like Johnny doesn't seem to have like anything that can just cleanly disrespect the traps the way like. Soul can or Anji could with Fujin apparently.
Yeah. Yeah, not a whole lot of like ways to outmaneuver or worm your way out there. Alright, so now we're in losers finals. This is once again best of five. Alright, so,
heaven or hell,
this is also the run back.
Yep.
And this was also 2-1 on the winner's side. So, in order to make it to grand finals, Jacob Pat has to play a bunch of fucking people that he already played. So far, he looks very comfortable. He looks like he's an element. Thank you for the raid, Stone. While we're here, now that we're capitalizing on the Stone raid, we're in top three. We're in losers finals. Make sure to use those Matcherito codes. Yeah. There's about 50 of you. There's 50 Matcherito codes on the table. So get those codes in so that top three can afford hats. Alright, yeah, Jacob Pat looking much more comfortable now than he was in Winners. So I, not to say that he wasn't, but definitely doing Testament shit, not letting Pichon play. Okay, but now Pichon
this
on the
round
way. Yeah.
Pretty thoroughly yeah. play around.
This looks, okay. This will probably be fine, like, in round three, but yeah. Okay, not quite a perfect, but...
Barely not perfect.
Okay, here we go again.
Doesn't want to deal with the X and B stuff.
Yeah. Good presence of mind to go low on the BBCs. Oh, whiffs. Okay, not able to punish the whiff Big Bang upper. Oh no, Force broke back in! Okay. Commentator's curse. As soon as I started hyping up Jacob Pat, Pichon was like, nah, son.
There's some pile drivers in your gut.
Yeah. Alright, so Pichon takes game one.
Heaven or hell, duel. One, let's rock.
Alright, once again, back into the corner with you. There's gotta be like at least two webs. Okay, he just fucking mobs through them.
How beat the Gravedigger?
Yeah, I guess so.
Yeah.
Whoa. Man, it's so crazy. Slayer, like you see a bunch of characters like in this game, like even the soul combos that are like sick nasty. Like that takes like a bunch of hits and like a
and
bunch
Slayer's
of,
just like, I'll just power drive you three times.
Yeah.
But hey, Testament can do Testament things.
That's also true.
One more hit! Super! Big tree! Okay, bust! Probably doesn't want to use this bust. Does use the bust.
Okay. Oh! Oh, goodness! Oh, no! Ah!
Got clipped!
Yeah. That was a black beat, too! Like, Jacob probably could have traded after the tech. Oh man, okay, whiff punishes with the Mappas. around the world, setting up exabees, cross ups, at least two webs.
Wonder with 6P being an overhead for some reason.
Yeah, catch the slide out, stay in the corner. This is it. Yeah, this is what Jacob Pat wants. Okay. Yes. Yeah. Yeah. If he can keep doing
and
that.
Got the bust off of that too.
Yeah. Oh, good jump. Yeah, really great safe jump. That might be what Jacob Pat needed.
Poison now.
Oh,
yeah,
God.
Poison,
yeah.
And the bust.
Yeah. Twice in a row. Two rounds in a row where Pichon had, like...
And that was a perfect.
Yeah. Bringing it, like, yeah, exactly. What a great call out to how game one went. Two bursts in a row where Pichon, like, burst into... Like, testament set play, essentially.
Yeah.
And then it got rocked. Alright. Okay, Burns burst early. This is what Pichon likes to see, because. Especially without
yeah,
Mir.
I like that bust that it pushed Pichon into the corner into this bad situation. And now. That's a lot of damage.
Yeah. Great side switch. This is exactly what Jacob Pat wants. Oh, goodness.
Trying to guts crush there, and did end up getting there.
Oh! Wow!
Got the dust! The Danny just going straight into
yeah,
it.
No kidding. That was some Faust shit.
Yeah.
Okay.
Why does Faust 5D have invul, by the way?
I don't know. Oh, man.
Just a funny guy.
Yeah.
Okay, pile driver.
Okay.
And pile driver. Yeah. That takes the round.
This game's looking much more back and forth for both players.
Yep.
A kajillion webs. These webs are probably just as much for setting traps as they are for, like, extending Jacob's airtime, right? Oh, what the... Reversal throw out of the XV's tree setup. Oh, no.
Projectile. Flips the dandy step with false slash. Okay, the bust that time did not get baited, just connects.
Ooh! Okay, no capitalization on the stagger, but. Not looking. Yeah, there you go.
Yeah, trap plus exabeast is a rough setup there.
Alright, so now Jacob Pat up in the set. So far, a turnaround from when they played in Winner's Side, because that was Pichon Killer who won 2-1. So, for the total run back, Jacob Pat still needs to win one more game, but if this had happened earlier in their bracket, Jacob Pat would have redeemed himself. Alright, both players have already spent burst. Neither player wants to deal with any, like, round start bullshit.
I have power driver, real big damage. 2H to get this all started. And now it's testament time. Let's see how Pichon deals with it this time.
It's been really tough.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah.
Okay, uses the dandy FB to try and get out, and gets the last hit they needed.
So far, it looks like the openings that Pichon Killer has been capitalizing on are, like, Okay, I need 25 meter, or I need burst, or I need Jacob Path in this space's beating.
Oh, punishes a burst with goal.
Yeah, burst really goal. Great stuff. That's the third situation. He's like, okay, if I wait for Jacob Pat to misspace my meaty, then, or his meaty, then I'll just throw him. And then I'll get my stuff going again. Oh, good dead angle.
Dead angle.
Okay. One round away from moving on to grand finals. Yeah, Pichon Killer not gonna make it easy for him though. Bang upper. Clash!
Not actually connecting, but did dodge.
Oh boy. Okay, 2-2 right now.
All the marbles.
Yeah, what a tough opponent right now.
Heaven or hell? Duel. One, let's rock!
Clash the 6P.
Yeah. Oh, you snuck a burst out. Okay. None of the burst space that we were seeing in game 2. At least none of the successful ones.
An ID.
Blackbeat.
Into Blackbeat stuff. Okay, dead angle.
Oh boy.
But the FB power bunker just gets there.
Alright, Pichon now.
Boy,
on
extra beast
point.
Could properly come out.
It doesn't matter if Jacob Pat puts himself into the corner because he'll just keep the block string pressure going. He could side switch at any moment. Pichon has not been able to do anything but FD this entire round.
Okay, bust back now. Don't think you want to use it this round.
Yeah,
save it for
the
next round. Last round.
Alright, both players. Whoever wins this has to fight Jason. Both of them really want it. Alright, sweep. Testament.
For the blender. Jay Super time.
Alright.
Victory.
So we have to keep an eye out. We have 50 meter here. Oh, gets tripped up on the 2K.
Wings gets there.
Okay, has to spin. Oh no!
Jeez.
All right. Yeah.
That was really down to the wire.
Yeah.
Yeah. Getting out of the doll corner was very important for Pichon there. Didn't have to deal with any of that thanks to that power driver just knocking Jacob way far away.
Wait, hey!
Whoa.
Alright, well, in the meantime, I'll go ahead.
Everyone loves mashing P, don't they?
In the meantime, I'll go get Jason.
I want to see some poetry, please. Please give me some poetry.
Oh, they just disconnected.
Ah, I want to see poetry.
Yeah, I can't the runner.
Okay.
Jacob denied us poetry.
Alright, so now. This is Grand Finals. So that'd be Jason Riot versus Bichon Keller.
Jason on Windows side.
So they put the L on Pichon's name.
And the audio balancing of Plus R is really something.
So this was a set that we barely, like, narrowly avoided seeing.
Wild throws the big bang up on in the startup. Okay. Sidewinder time. Bus safe. Just restart the sidewinders.
Yeah, Jason's still feeling comfortable here. I mean, Bichon's riding a lot of momentum. But we'll see if he can earn this upset. So far, so good. Jason's got impeccable defense, but. You know, still some stray hits here and there. Finally getting a hit on.
Twice heal. But, Volcanic Viper is the superior uppercut. Ah, Grand Viper. Did not get the clean hit. Got
there
the clean
we go.
Hit that time.
Yeah.
There we
Dust
go.
Dust Winder. Okay.
Three of them.
Yeah. Oof.
Was hoping to catch the recovery of the Gunflame with the Tunnel Wings, but not quite.
Alright, here we go. So Jason up game one.
Punishes the burst with Wild Throw Sidewinder. Four of them. Five total.
Oh! Air Throat reset! Okay, drops. Another one!
Drops, quote unquote.
Yeah. Jason
no
Ryan.
No such thing as drops, just reset.
Yeah, Jason Ryan is the fucking FGC Bob Ross that we all aspire to be. Whoa. Okay. Doesn't want to get crossed up and for like pressing on a wake up situation, so he's gonna keep defending.
That's the stage and whoopty whoop right there.
Yeah, no kidding. Yeah, it's like we're seeing Strive right before our eyes. There's a bunch of these. Oh, just raw. Yeah, that's why you don't press it raw, Tux.
Because
then we're just gonna jump over it and mash on you. All right. Bichon feeling a little bit better in game two. Okay, 2K Bandit 2D
is,
or 2D.
2D
yeah.
So good. So is 5K. Blocks the bus too.
Whoa.
Player damage still.
Oh goodness.
Oh,
Okay.
JP is like, you can't backdash me.
Okay, yeah. Jason keeps doing safe jump JH, knowing that, like, either he gets the hit or he just lands for free.
Okay. One more hit, though.
6Ps, dandies. Oh, God. Yeah.
VVs through the dandy step move.
Alright, yeah. Jason looking to end this quickly so that he can go to bed, make it on time for his Frosty's flight that he never actually made. Still can't believe it. He was seated number two and is not gonna show up. Fucking Jason Bryan.
It's like the most in character.
Yeah.
To get that gold.
I mean, most of my local scene like canceled their flights.
Yeah, I guess that makes sense. But Jason just didn't know that he was going.
I don't know if Foo O'Brien or Beautiful Dude has or not.
Yeah.
It might be there.
It's Wise going, right? Pat paid for his flight.
Yeah. Grand Viper! Yeah, no clean hit though. Aww. They've been like 20% or 10 to 20% tonight.
Okay, here we go. Hoosies? Okay, no. Universe.
Whiffs the power bunker there. Now it's Jason's
son
with all these resources.
Ooh, wow.
5K's recovery was so short.
Oh, goodness. Throw. Oh, wow. JH and then lands safely to block the burst and is now on tournament point. That was also, like, we only had 17 seconds left on the timer. That really ran it down.
Yeah.
Are going around the world. Okay, cross up, but doesn't believe in the follow-up hits.
Crossrise and Big Bang.
Ooh, great burst bait.
Didn't do a punish off of it though, but okay.
Oh.
Blocked.
Yeah.
So Sidewinder, which should be it.
Oh, what the?
Oh, not quite.
Okay. Yeah, this is... okay.
Right stomp in the corner. Good old soul things.
Yeah. We all thought that was it after the Banner Revolver, but... Jason Ryan's like, no skin off my back. I will just, spoose right in. And,
yeah.
Is... Alright, so first of all, Jason Ryan is now your 12-time WNF champion. Here at Feliz Jueves. Second of all, Jason now has a bounty on his head. Once again. So I will go ahead and pull those bounty images up while Kimberly explains what the bounty entails.
Yeah, so, okay. So, well, it's not really a how much sort of deal, because we're broke as shit. So what we're doing instead is, if somebody either kicks Jason down into losers, or resets the bracket, or knocks him out, I will draw a Guilty Gear character of their choice. People seem to like the stuff that I draw. It is whatever. I have an art blog that I can link to.
So you can find. For the record, so the little jam behind my chat overlay, that is a stream asset drawn for me for my birthday by Kimberly. It is very nice. It is jam wielding my stick and a six pack of Tecate for Feliz Jueves. And then she's also drawn these as cash outs for the bounties that have been placed on that have been placed on Jason Ryan and others, I think. There's been other bounties, but Jason Ryan is mainly the victim of these. So...
Yeah. Go for it.
So you can see more of the art there on Kim's art blog. She has a Tumblr page. These are what the artworks look like. This was for Skeletal. And this was for Elven Shadow for their cash outs, respectively. So, this could be you! If you enter WNF next week, after coming down from the hype of the previous release of this and from Frosty Faustings, and you want to kick Jason Riot's ass, do it!
Yeah.
We'll get you some artwork. It's really good. It's really cool.
Please, more exciting Jason Riot games. Well, I get to see more interesting things because, like, you end up in situations that Jason doesn't usually end up in.
It's gonna be really cool. So push Jason to the ultimate limit in order to beat his ass and prevent his win streak from continuing. In the meantime, thanks again, everybody, for watching. I've been Light the Iron Man. This is Sammy here. Looks like she's having a dinner. I was joined tonight by, once again, my co-admin, Kim.
That's me.
And my co-commentator and eternal soul fiend, Tuxtev.
See ya.
Yeah, so that's gonna do it for us. Obviously, Pat's not here because Pat is gonna be. I don't have anybody to raid because Pat is on a flight to Frosty as well. So I'm just gonna call. Is there anybody else streaming Plus R right now? Chat, do you know anybody that's streaming Plus R right now? Let's take a look at the category. I'll just go raid whoever.
I mean, Julian's still on his Relius kick.
Oh, hang on. Beautiful
so
dude.
Apparently not going to Frosty, because at home playing Relius.
Okay, yeah, I fucking guess so. Alright, let's go raid Beautiful Dude. When you get to the stream, tell him the cow sent you. As always, stay safe, stay healthy, play Guilty Gear. If you are planning to go to Frosty, or you're already there, be sure to stay safe. Seriously, wear a mask.
Be safe.
Yeah,
for real.
That way we can actually have more Frosties and, like, combo breakers and CEOs, etc. Through the rest of the year. Take care of yourselves. I'll see you guys next week for more WNF action. I'm not going to be streaming over the next couple days because I want to watch Frosties. I'll see you guys next week for more WNF. Have a good rest of your Feliz Jueves, everybody.
And here's one that the most unbelievable of all. It says, kill your friends guilt-free.